Greetings and welcome, everyone. I am Dr. Wolf, and I'm here at Ponycon 2017, which is a little weird because I flew all the way out to the East Coast in late January, even though I was all the way out on the West Coast in early January. I don't know how I'm going to be handling them at the conventions this year, but it's going to be an interesting experiment. But one thing that I was really looking forward to, and I finally managed to pull off, even though I had all these different chances at other conventions before, we always seem to miss each other for one reason or another, but I finally managed to locate Crowne Prince. You want to say hi, Crowne Prince?
Hi, everyone.
Yeah?
So, yeah, actually, we've been at, I don't know how many conventions together now, maybe four, because I think every BronyCon, and there was one point where we were outside the main doors, standing, like, maybe 10 feet away, but we each had large groups of people around us, and it just was not going to
Neither of us knew that the other was there, is the
I knew
thing.
You were there. You were just busy.
I didn't even know that you were there.
Because nobody knows what I look like,
right.
So.
She's actually an animator in the community, and we've worked together on several different projects. What comes to mind is Pinkie Pie's therapy visit and Rarity's therapy visit, which, by the way, I was really tickled when you were surprised that it turned out to be the same voice actress for both characters.
Yeah, well, it just happened because I wasn't even going to be animating that one, but I end up picking up pieces when people are like, no, I have school and I'm too busy and I can't do it. So I said, okay, I'm free, I'll do it.
And anyways, I did want to thank you personally for all the very entertaining work that you did on Pony Python and the Holy Grail in particular.
That's a good one.
That was so much fun. But this vlog, we're actually doing in a bit of a lab. As you can see here, we have a whole bunch of laptops set up, and a whole bunch of people are trying to install programs on them. You want to explain what you're trying to have happen here?
Oh, so at PonyCon, they actually set up a computer lab, and I teach an animation class in here. And we also have Silver Quill is going to be teaching a vectoring workshop in here, and Legends of Equestria, which is a game you can play, is going to have like an open gaming session. You can come and play the game. So right now, what you're seeing is the inside of a convention, which a lot of people don't. As an attendee, you come and you have a great time, but you don't really think about what goes into making it happen. So you're sort of seeing the inside right now, where you've got a bunch of volunteers and people who are available just trying to get all these programs installed on these computers for tomorrow. So that's what's going on.
And basically, when this happened last year, this room was overflowing, that there wasn't not only not enough computers, not enough seats for people to partake in this. So
yeah, well, it's obviously really popular because a lot of the times you go to the convention and you have a panel where you sit and you listen to some people talk. Here, you're actually doing something. You get to make an animation. So it's really popular. We only have 25 laptops. So what we end up doing is saying, can you share a laptop? Or if you've already made an animation, maybe give a laptop to someone who hasn't tried it before. And then we have lots of back row seating because last year when I did this workshop, like people would see that what was going on, they come in and we have people standing along the walls to be able to listen because you could still get the lesson. You just don't have the opportunity to do it yourself. So yeah, hugely popular.
She's actually been relating a lot of very interesting stories about all the hiccups that go into every single convention, just unexpected disasters that drop at the very last minute. And I'm hoping that one of these days you actually do a video of your own explaining all of the frustration that goes into making everything run as smoothly as possible
at
a convention.
Well, it's funny because when you do a conference or a convention, because I planned a conference before this and I started up last year just an online convention, what will happen is you're all ready, your volunteers are all ready, and then people show up and something goes wrong. But it all gets handled. It's just, you don't really see that stuff happen on the inside. I mean, even now, we were trying to do this vlog and we have like the convention owner coming in to check in his laptops and do you have the power cords? And all the vendors are getting set up in the vendor hall over there right now. So it's like, wait, we don't have any power and blah, 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 and this and that. So like con ops, if you've ever volunteered for convention operations room, you see a lot of people coming in, you know, this problem, that problem. It all gets solved behind the scenes.
I'm learning a lot this evening. And I'm hoping that a few of you better appreciate all of the time volunteers put into these conventions. I know that maybe you'd only go for a couple of days and spend all of your time browsing the vendor hall and listening to panels and having a grand old time. Seeing folks like even Silver Quill way back there trying to tinker with laptops and make sure that there's as much...
Oh my God!
Great timing on that alarm, by the way. I thought you were always the culprit. It's fun stuff that goes on at all these things, I have to admit. But there is one other gentleman that I ran into that I actually have gone to conventions before and actually have had a chance to sit and chat with. May I present Voice of Reason?
How you doing, everybody?
Yeah. This is actually a lot closer to your home, Ponycon, here.
Yeah, it's about a train ride and a half. It's like two train rides, right? Because I live on Long Island, and the trains I have to take two trains, which is already an expensive ride. Yeah, because the MTA on Long Island is like the most expensive public transportation in the United States. So I have that plus New Jersey Transit, and it's actually a lot better than just driving down, because then you have to take the New Jersey Transit, which is a mess in itself. But yeah, like, I decided to come to this convention because I think the Ponycon guys actually invited me while I was at PhillyCon back in August of last year. And I thought, hey, why not? I'll come down and do some fun stuff.
Consider yourself lucky that you didn't have to fly more than halfway across the country in order to get here, though.
Yeah, I heard that. Yeah, I just find it funny because you, like, early in the year, you were on the West Coast for San Diego. Now you have to fly to the East Coast actually, is it colder weather or is it about the same from San Diego?
Compared to San Diego, it was actually nice in San Diego this year. Coming to this hotel, which is a very nice hotel, and I got to show you some of the lounge area in particular, you're going to freeze your ears off even just walking a few blocks to get from the train station into the hotel. But the hotel itself is very, very nice.
Yeah, just walking in, it was gorgeous. I think I actually put some fresh paint in. When I went into my hotel room, it looked like they smelled like they actually put some fresh paint in on, I think I'm on the 10th floor. But it looks nice. It got a great view from our balcony. I could see both the beach and the town from where I am. Mm. And yeah, looking forward to having a really fun convention. I got a panel of my own on Saturday night around 10.
Yeah.
Gonna do a live review. Sort of in the style of sort of like Silver Quill's After the Fact Lives and Linkara's Atop the Fourth Wall Lives, which should be really fun, and I hope people can attend.
We've actually got a TF2 Analysis Anarchy panel that's going to be coming up on Saturday as well. We've got three episodes unreleased that we're hoping to show off to the public, and I want to see people's reactions. I'm hoping there's going to be a lot of people that show up for this, because if we do get enough, I might be able to record a live reaction, but we'll see.
Yeah, I think I know of two of them. I'm not sure about the third one. I won't say anything. You'll have to find out on when it gets released.
Right. I'd love to see his reaction too. At any rate, much to do, much to look forward to. We've been trying to help with the computer lab, and maybe in a little while we'll actually find time to sit down and eat something. I don't think I've eaten in the past 8 or 10 hours, but we'll find something. Until next time, I am Dr. Wolf, and I look forward to hearing from you.